ago that we went on a trip to Tennessee and we got some fun stuff at a really cool store.
Yeah, I don't remember you filming that much. Was that an actual order?
No, I didn't do any filming. So what I did was I did a haul last week for what we got at the Gimme Five.
Did you even include the part from the car?
No, I didn't.
No. She was like, oh, we're going to vlog on this trip, and we never did.
Nope, we didn't. So, I will leave a link below to the video with the haul that I did, because it will include the things that we're going to talk about today. We've got three tees here, two different brands, and let's get started.
Sure.
So this first one that we're going to try is a green tea blend, which I know is your absolute favorite, Daniel.
No.
I was being sarcastic. It's the Emporium brand, Orange Blossom Mint, and it says that the ingredients in this are green tea, whole peppermint, jasmine blossoms, pink rose buds, and flavoring. This one definitely smells very fragrant. When I was putting it in.
Oh, yeah.
You can smell the floweriness of it. Mm. So, let's give it a try.
It's not bad for green tea.
Mm-mm, not at all. I don't taste any of the peppermint.
Really, I do. You get the little bit of cooling sensation underneath all the floral taste you got there.
Yeah, I can taste the rose buds and the jasmine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very floral, but it's got that sort of cooling sensation from the peppermint.
And it doesn't taste like you can't really taste the green tea.
Oh, yeah, you don't taste the grass. You don't really taste the grass and the green tea. So.
And again, if you guys missed my last video, so when we were in Tennessee, we went to this store called Gimme a Five. It's basically an overstock store for Amazon and stores like Amazon, online stores like Amazon, where we basically dug through a bunch of bins to find things, and we got everything that day for $5. The way they do things is the restock day, they sell items for $5. They go to $3 the next day, $1 the next day, and 25 cents the last day they have everything in the bin, and then they restock again, and everything goes back to $5. So this actually was not in that store, but they have three stores.
A Half Price food one that was right next door, and then there's a clothing one like around the block that we didn't go to.
And all three of those stores are all connected. They're all Gimme a Five stores. They separated the food and the clothing, and I go into a little bit more detail about that in my last video. So again, I will link that below. But actually, the day that we went, because it was Memorial Day weekend, we got our items that we purchased there for half off. So this may say $3.50 on here, but I got this huge 250-gram bag for $1.75. And Aunt Shell was the one that told me to look at this brand because she said it was really good. So far, with this tea, I really enjoy it. So hopefully,
this one's actually, the more I drink it, the better it is.
Yeah?
I do enjoy this one.
Well, you can take some home with you. Mom yelled at me, actually, when I told her that I was sending home some tea with you. But,
okay.
So the next one.
I'm going to die tomorrow anyway.
So the next one that I have is the same brand. It's the Emporium brand. Again, it's that 250-gram bag, and I did get this one for $1.75 as well. This is the Honey Mead Black Tea Blend. It has black tea, apple pieces, sultanas, apple cubes, flavoring, freeze-dried sour cherry pieces, and propolis. What is propolis?
That is a good question.
That's honey, isn't it?
Sure. I don't know about nature and things.
I'm pretty sure that's honey. Or some... I don't know. But anyway, this is a black tea blend, like I said, so it's a little bit, and it smelled really good. So when I was scooping this one out, there were a lot more pieces. So, you need more Jelly Bellies.
Uh-huh.
there were a lot more pieces in this one, so I did try to include like a bunch of fruit in each one. So let's. Can you smell how fruity that is?
This is the tea. the equivalent of a Honeycrisp apple. Apple.
It is.
Great at speaking today.
It is. You've got that apple flavor in there, that little bit of honey.
It smells divine.
It smells really good. This is the one that I told you when I opened it to put it in the tea strainer. The one that, like, I had to take a step back because it smelled so strongly.
Yeah, I like this one a lot, too. What was it called? Emporium.
I'm going to try and find them on Amazon and link them below for everyone, for you guys, too. So that way, if you wanted to purchase them or wanted to look into what kind of price they are, without the discount that we got, you guys could do that. So.
Or you could go to Tennessee.
I'm pretty sure that's where all the Gimme a Five stores are. There's like 4 or 5 of them, and they're all located in different parts of Tennessee and southern Kentucky. I think there's 1 or 2 in southern Kentucky.
I have coffee one again.
Yeah. Wash it down with some tea. There you go.
Coffee Jelly Bellies are the worst. Jelly Bellies fight me.
Every time he's come over the last couple of months, I've had this giant 3-pound container of Jelly Bellies.
How are you?
And since my father-in-law gets them for me for Christmas, but since Josh and I have been trying to, like, watch what we eat and stuff, I have not really eaten any, so.
I don't see the purpose of that.
See the purpose of what?
Watching what you eat when you have this giant thing of jelly beans.
They're good every once in a while if I need, like
worry about this first, then worry about your body, you know what I mean?
Not sure that's how that works, babe.
That's how you gotta live your life.
Are you ready to move on to the next one?
I guess.
So this next one is Tea Forte Rare Imperial Tea. It's the Golden Monkey Yunnan Black Tea Blend. So when I opened this, you get all these little packets. There are 12 packets in here. So originally, when I opened this to steep it, I thought these were tea bags, but no. I'm not going to open this because that would be a waste of tea, and I'm not going to make another cup. But if this is loose tea in these packets. They measured out a teaspoon of tea for you.
Why do they call it Golden Monkey?
I don't know. So the back of the box says, from Yunnan, China, this spring plucking is famously comprised of only one leaf and one bud resembling a monkey paw. Wonderfully fragrant and beautifully twisted golden leaves yield a full-bodied cup rich with notes of malt and apricot.
Okay.
So, that would be why, because the buds look like monkey paws.
Gotcha.
So it's golden monkey, and they're a golden color.
Gotcha.
So, golden monkey.
Golden monkey.
All right, let's give this a try. This is just a regular black tea. This is something I would drink in the morning. This is good.
There's something about it that's off. You said there's apricot in there?
It says rich with notes of malt and apricot.
I think I'm getting the apricot. I don't like apricots very much. Oh, also it's organic.
Yeah.
That's stupid.
You and your thing for against organic. These are not organic, are they?
That's how they were significantly better than this one.
This one also doesn't have any sweetening agents in it the way the other two did.
Fair.
Like, the other two had, like, fruit or something in them that made them taste a little
sweeter. It's
got
apricot. Isn't that supposed to be sweet as a fruit?
I don't think it is. I can't taste the apricot.
I don't know. There's something on it. You're right. It is basically like a regular black tea, but there's something off about it.
He has to have flavored tea in order for it to be good to him.
I drink plenty of plain straight black tea.
Yeah?
Yeah. Not this.
Just not this.
Not this.
I don't know. I think it tastes good. I think it's, like I said, just a regular.
I think
black
it's
tea.
Fine, I guess. But
it's a little lighter in flavor than some other black teas that I've had, though. Like, what's it called? There's a tea shop in Maumee. There's a tea shop near here that sells this black tea blend that's called Lady Catherine.
Mm.
And it's so rich and dark. that I actually, it, when I drink it, like, I can only handle small amounts of it because it is so strong and so, like, it just packs a punch.
This isn't so bad when you keep drinking it.
So your initial reaction was like,
That first step, I was like, something not right. I didn't hate it.
Well, and it could be that you still had the flavor of the other one in your mouth. And it just didn't cleanse my palate. It hadn't cleansed your palate. Or it could be the fact that you're eating Jelly Bellies.
Okay. We'll bring the Jelly Bellies in this.
No, I really like this one. This one is gonna, you're not taking it.
That's fine. Official rankings for me, I like the first one the best. The second way, I honestly win the order we drank them. The first one I thought was great. I liked that I like pretty things that are relatively floral. I especially like the peppermint. You didn't really taste very like bold peppermint, but you got sort of that cooling effect. This one was really good. Like I said, it was a lot like the tea version of a Honeycrisp apple. That being said, apple's not my favorite thing. I'll eat or drink apple flavored things, but meh. This one was a black tea. Seemed kind of off when I first started drinking it. And the more you drink it, it's fine.
So, rankings for me are pretty much the same. I liked the green tea. It's very light. Something that you could drink in the afternoon just before being done, like, drinking caffeinated beverages, if you're like me, who's very sensitive to caffeine. The honey mead, I honestly, this would be a perfect tea for the fall. This one would be perfect in the fall. So, like, you wake up in the morning and you have a cup of this honey mead, and it's because
it's the apple, yeah.
Yeah, because it's got that perfect blend of apple. It's got that really bold, fruity smell. Mm-hmm. And to me, it just tasted and smelled like fall. Honestly, that's what I kept thinking every time I took a sip of it, was this would be perfect in the fall. The Golden Monkey, like I said, this is one that I could drink every morning, because I don't drink, like, super flavorful things in the morning, mostly because when I just wake up, I just want a cup of tea. It's like, I don't know, I don't really do well with flavored things in the morning.
Yeah, when I wake up, I want to die.
No, since I've stopped drinking coffee for, you know, sleep reasons, I have been really reaching for a cup of tea in the morning, and actually I'm not even reaching for a cup of tea as often as I was before. So the Golden Monkey, this one will definitely be something that I look for in my drawer in the morning. I still have that lavender Earl Grey that we did when we did the Earl Grey, and it's too strong for me in the morning. Like, I can't handle that much.
Yeah.
Like, because it's literally like a punch in the face. That
more
lavender
of a brunch
flavor.
Tea.
Yes. A brunch tea with, like, crepes and fruit and cream. And, like, it's just, it's too much. So, like, that's why I like to drink, like, my Lady Grey. Or that Earl Grey Jasmine. I still have some of that. That's really good in the morning because it's nice and subtle. All right, so that is it. I'm putting these back down because they're very tall.
And we're not.
That is it for today's video. Like I said, I'm going to try and find these on Amazon and link them for you guys below. I will also leave a link to the Give Me a 5 store below. They do have a website. You can go ahead and see what locations are close to you. If there are locations close to you, because I'm pretty sure...
We personally know all 5 people who are going to watch this, and none of them live in Tennessee.
Connor lives in Tennessee,
and he started following me.
And I've got 10 subscribers now, so...
Crazy.
Anyway, if you guys, if you don't live in Tennessee, maybe you'd want to visit somewhere near one of the stores. I'll leave the link below for the Give Me a 5 stores. Maybe it'll give you, like, a destination or something
maybe.
For a vacation. Because it's summertime, and vacations are, you know, that's when a lot of people take vacations. Mm-hmm. It's during the summer. Except for us, we take vacations like.
You know, we do it when we want.
Yeah, basically. We're not in school anymore.
Trendsetters.
Anyway, like I said, I'll try to leave links for everything in the description box below. If you liked this video, hit that thumbs up button, and I will try and do more tea videos like this. Because, like I said in the past, Josh and I are planning on doing a little more traveling. We like to investigate and explore new places. So we'll try and find some tea places along the way, or some tea that we haven't tried yet for Daniel and I to try in a video. And make sure you subscribe so you can see more videos like this. I'll also leave a link below to my last video, which has my whole haul from Give Me a Five, including the three teas that we just drank, and everything else that I was able to find, because there were a couple of finds that were super surprising. So again, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe. Leave comments below if you have any suggestions for other videos you'd like to see, and we'll see you guys again soon. Bye.